In this video, we are going to compare a spring and a bar of material. So a spring has a spring constant K and an initial length L naught, and a material, a bar of materials, that is a linear elastic bar of material, has an elastic modulus E and a cross-sectional area A and the same length L naught. So what we want to do is we want to see if a bar of material, its properties with respect to the force applied and change in length, can be represented by a spring of equivalent spring constant K. So let's start with a spring. Raise the bar. So a spring can be represented by the squiggly line, and it has an initial length of L naught and a spring constant of K. So upon stretching it, so we apply a force, so it becomes longer, and the new length is L. So we apply the force F, let's say, and if the spring is attached to a wall, the wall might apply the same force F so that the spring does not change in position, it just changes in length. And now, according to Hooke's law, if this is a linear Hookean spring, then force equals to K times the change in length, L minus L naught. And so this is equals to K, let's say L minus L naught is delta L. So let's move on to the bar. So the bar can be of any weird cross-sectional area. So let's say it's kind of like this, but the cross-sectional area has to be constant throughout. So if you take any cross-section, it has the same kind of shape. And so this cross-sectional area is A, and the elastic modulus of the material, this is a homogeneous material, is E, and the length of the material, the length of the bar, is L naught. So the stress developed in the material is equals to the elastic modulus times strain, and the stress is defined as the force per unit area, and elastic modulus is elastic modulus, or Young's modulus it's also called, and strain is the change in length, so let's say the new length is L divided by the original length, so this means the force is equals to elastic modulus times area times change in length divided by the original length. So if you compare this equation with this equation, then the spring constant of this material is K is equals to E A divided by L naught. So what does this mean? If you take a stiffer material, the elastic modulus or Young's modulus is higher, and the equivalent spring constant for the same geometry is higher. And if you take the same material of the same length and then double the area, the spring constant will double. So if you want to adjust the spring constant, equivalent spring constant of a bar of material, you can adjust, you can use a stiffer material, or you can just use a material with a larger cross-sectional area. And if you use a material of a different length, then you will be able to achieve a larger change in length. If you use, for example, if you use a material of double the length, then for the same force, You'll get the same stress for the same area, but you'll get double the length chains for the same strain. So if you are okay with increasing the length of the bar, then you can also achieve a change in the spring constant by a change in length. But if you want to keep the length the same, then the spring constant is determined by the elastic modulus and area.